Hi guys, today we are going to see how you can host multiple websites on the same hosting plan. Let's say you want to launch multiple sites on the internet. Now instead of getting a separate hosting for all your sites, you want to host your websites in a single hosting plan. You can do that easily by watching this video. So after watching this video, you will be able to create multiple websites on a single hosting plan, like this, and you can manage all your websites in one single place. So this will help you save a lot of time and money, which you spend on many hosting plans. Okay, I'm Brian from Website Learners, and let's get started. So to host different websites, first, you need to pick a hosting plan, which allows you to create multiple websites on the same plan. We recommend you webspacekit. This hosting provider has a hosting plan where you can host multiple websites on a single hosting. Now in this video, we will see how you can host multiple websites on a single hosting using webspacekit. First, let's see how you can get your domain and hosting. So to get your domain and hosting, just click the link below this video and it will take you to webspacekit. This is the place where we are going to get our domain and hosting. Now here, enter the name you want for your website. As I've already picked a name for my site, which is techielead.com, I'm going to enter that and click search. And as you can see, our domain name is available. Once you choose your name, let's see how you can get this domain name and hosting. Now to get this domain name and hosting, let's click add to cart. And then click continue. Now it will ask us to choose our hosting plan. Here you can see how many websites you can host on each plan. So based on the number of websites that you want to build, you can choose a plan here. As I want to build multiple websites, I'm going to choose this plan. Now here you can choose how long you want the hosting for. I'm going to choose 12 months. And click continue. Now here you can see that we're getting our domain name, which is techielead.com, for free, and our hosting. Now both of these are valid for 1 year, which means once we complete this purchase, our site will be live on the internet for 1 year. So to get our domain and hosting, let's fill up these details. Now here, select your payment method, enter your details, and click order now. Okay, so now we've successfully placed our order and we've got a domain and hosting. So now if we click here, you can see here, we have successfully got our hosting and domain. Okay. So once you've got your domain and hosting, your website should now be live on the internet. So to check that, let's open a new tab. Now if we type techielead.com and press enter, you can see that we have a brand new website on the name which we selected. Now sometimes, it might take a few minutes for the domain to become active on the internet. So if it doesn't work for you, try refreshing after 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, once your website is launched, next, let's see how you can log into your WordPress website. So to log into your site, all you have to do is, just click here, type /wp-admin after your site's address, and then press enter.
Now here you need to enter your username and password to log into your WordPress dashboard. Now once your site is active, you should have received the login details of WordPress in your email. So let's go to our inbox
and you can see we have got this email. Just open it. As you can see, we have the username and password. So let's copy this and paste it here. Now let's copy the password. Paste it here
and then click Login. You can see that we have successfully logged into our WordPress site, and this is our WordPress dashboard. Now this is the place where you can control your site.
So now we have successfully got our first website on the internet. Okay, next, let's see how you can create another website on this same hosting.
Let's say you want to create a subdomain like this. How can you do that? Now, subdomain is a separate website which comes under your main domain name, which helps you to organize your website content. So for example, let's take maps.google.com. Now this is a separate website which comes under google.com. Okay, so now let's see how you can host a subdomain in your hosting. So to create a subdomain, let's go to this tab. Click here. And scroll down. Then click WordPress Manager. And it'll take you to this page. Now click New Installation. And here enter the name for your subdomain. I'm going to enter support.techylead.com. Now here you can change the username you want. I'm going to change it. Now make a note of this username and password. You will need this to log into your subdomain. I'm going to copy this username and password and save it to my notes. Once you're done, just click Create. And here you can see that we have now successfully created the subdomain. Once you have created your subdomain, WebspaceKit automatically installs WordPress and your site will be live on the internet. So to check that, just click here. Now here you can see that we have got a brand new site on the subdomain we created. Once you have created your subdomain, now to log into the site, all you have to do is just click here, type /wp-admin after your site's address. And then press enter. Now here you need to enter your username and password to log into your WordPress dashboard. As we already saved the username and password in our notes, let's open it. Now copy these details and paste it here. Now copy the username and paste it here. Then copy this password and paste it here. Once you have entered these details, click Login. Now as you can see, we have now logged into our WordPress site, and this is the WordPress dashboard for the subdomain we created.
Okay, so this is how you can create a subdomain. So now we've successfully launched two different sites on this hosting. Now let's say you've got a domain from a different hosting provider and you want to host that domain with our hosting. How will you do that? Now in order to host a domain from a different provider, we need to add the IP address of our host to that domain. So next, let's see how you can add another domain and create a site on this hosting plan. So to do that, we are going to do two steps. The first step is to grant your domain with your hosting.
As I have my domain with GoDaddy, let's go there. Here you can find your domain name. Now to add the IP address of WebspaceKit to this domain, click DNS, and you will get these details. Now you need to add the IP address to this A record. Now to change IP address, click here. Now here you need to enter the IP address of our host. So to get the IP address, let's go to our inbox and open the email which you have received after purchasing the hosting. Now scroll down. Here you can see that we have got an IP address of WSK. Now, to connect the domain with our hosting, you need to copy this IP address. And paste it here. Once you're done, click Save.
Okay, so now we have successfully connected the domain with our hosting. Once you have connected your domain, now to launch your website, we can go to step 2, which is to install WordPress in this domain. So to install WordPress, let's go back to WebspaceKit.
And click here. Now scroll down, click WordPress Manager. And it'll take you to this page. Now click New Installation. And here, enter your domain name. I'm going to enter findtechie.com. Now here you can change the username you want. I'm going to change it. Now make a note of this username and password. You will need this to log into your website. I'm going to copy this username and password and save it. Once you do that, just click Create and WordPress will be installed. And here you can see that we have now successfully connected another domain with our hosting. Once you have connected your domain, your site will be live on the internet. So to check that, let's open a new tab. Now if you go to findtechie.com, you can see that we have got a brand new website on the domain we connected. Now you can log into the site by typing /wp-admin.
Okay, we have now successfully launched different websites with the same hosting plan. Now let's say you want to get a new domain and launch another site with our hosting. You can do that by registering a new domain on the same hosting. As we already launched 3 websites, we have reached the limit on this plan. Now, in order to launch another site,
first, you need to delete the existing site from here. Now, before you delete your site, make sure you take a backup of your site so that you will not lose your site's data. Now, if you want to know how to backup your site, you can watch this video. Okay, now if you want to delete this site, just click here. And click Confirm. As soon as you click Confirm, your site will be deleted from this hosting. Once you're done, let's see how you can get a new domain. So to do that, we are going to do 2 steps. The first step is to get a new domain. So to purchase a new domain, let's go back to WebspaceKit and click Dashboard. Now here, enter the domain name you want. And click Register. Once your domain name is available, to get this domain, click Add to Cart. Then click Continue. And it will take you to this page. Now here, select your payment method. Enter your details. And click Order Now. So now we have successfully placed our order and we have got our domain. Now if you click here and click Domains, you can see that we have now purchased a new domain. Once you've purchased your domain, now to launch a new site on this domain, we can go to step 2,
we just installed WordPress in this domain. Before you install WordPress, first, you need to delete the DNS zone of your domain. So to delete the DNS zone, click Manage DNS. Now here you can see that this is the DNS zone of the domain we created. So to delete it, just click here and click Confirm. As you can see, the DNS zone has been deleted. Once you delete it, now to install WordPress, click Dashboard and click here. Scroll down, then click WordPress Manager and it will take you to this page. Now click New Installation. And here, enter your domain name. I'm going to enter plantechie.com. Now here you can change the username you want. I'm going to change it. Okay. Now as we did before, make a note of this username and password to log into your site later. I'm going to copy this username and password and save it to my notepad. Once you've done that, just click Create. Now here you can see that we have now successfully installed WordPress. Once you install WordPress, your site will be live on the internet. So to check that, let's open a new tab. Now if you go to plantechie.com, you can see that we have got a new website on the domain we created. Okay, now if you want to log into this site, all you have to do is just click here, type /wp-admin after your site's address and then press enter. Now here you need to enter your username and password to log into your WordPress dashboard. As we already saved our username and password in our notes, let's open it. Now just copy these details and paste it here. Once you have entered the details, click Login. Now you can see that we have got a brand new website on the domain we created. So now we have successfully launched 3 different websites on this hosting plan.
Okay, so that's it guys. Now you know how to create multiple websites on the same hosting plan. If you want to know how to migrate your site to a new host, you can watch this video. Also, make sure you click the subscribe button to see more videos from us. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.